Hello everyone, you are listening to Professor Rajendra Tadakhe, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Marathwada Mitramandals College of Engineering, Karvenagar, Pune. I welcome you all to the series of lectures on the theory of machine 1. This is our 7th lecture and the today's topic is acceleration analysis by relative velocity method. So in earlier 3 lectures, we have studied about the velocity analysis by using the relative velocity method. So construction of velocity diagram or the velocity polygon forms the basic step or the prior step to the acceleration analysis by relative velocity method. So as we are going to discuss and we are going to analyze the problems based on the acceleration analysis by using a relative velocity method. So before we proceed further, we will try to understand some basics related to the acceleration analysis. Then we'll try to understand what are the various steps involved, and then we will move further towards the problem statement. So first of all, we will try to understand the acceleration diagram for a rigid link. So with the help of this, we will try to understand what are the different components of accelerations are there when the link is rotating with the constant angular velocity or when it is having a angular acceleration. So for this, let's consider this link AB. So now this link AB is rotating with the angular velocity omega and angular acceleration alpha. So during this, it is having a 2 component of acceleration. So first component is called as normal component of acceleration, which acts along the link or parallel to the link. So this is the normal component of acceleration. And the second component is called as tangential component acceleration, which is perpendicular to the link, or we can say it is parallel to the velocity vector for the given link. That is, if you draw the velocity vector of the link AB, then the tangential component of acceleration of link AB will be parallel to the velocity vector of AB. So here is the tangential component of acceleration of the link AB. So as discussed above, the acceleration of a particle whose velocity changes in magnitude and direction at any instant has 2 components. So the first component is called as normal component, or it is also called as centripetal or radial component, as it acts towards the center of rotation. Okay, so this component of acceleration is along the link, that is parallel to the link or perpendicular to the velocity of the particle at the given instant, and we denote the normal component of acceleration as an. So how to find the magnitude of the normal component of acceleration? So we are having the standard formula for the force, which is equal to mass into the acceleration. So at the same time, if I consider the formula for the centrifugal force, then it is mv square upon r. So these are the 2 equations we are having with us. F is equal to ma and centrifugal force is equal to mv square upon r. So if I compare these 2 equations, then I get the value of A as V square by R. So A is equal to V square by R is nothing but the magnitude of normal component of acceleration. So the normal acceleration is equal to V square by R. So V is the linear velocity, which we can replace by V is equal to R omega. So we have substituted V is equal to R omega square divided by R, where R is the length of the link, is equal to, now this RR will get cancelled and we will left with R omega square. So the magnitude of normal component of acceleration of the given link is R omega square meter per second square. So this is the magnitude of normal acceleration and direction is along the link. Now we will talk about the tangential component of acceleration. So as discussed, this component of acceleration is perpendicular to the link or parallel to the velocity of the particle at the given instant, and it is denoted by A superscript T. So to calculate the magnitude of the tangential acceleration, we are having a basic formula of the linear velocity, which is V is equal to R omega. So this, if you consider the direction of this linear velocity, then it is always tangential. So if we differentiate this linear velocity with respect to time, then we will get the tangential acceleration. So let's differentiate this equation V is equal to R omega with respect to time. So we will get dV by dt is equal to R into d omega by dt. So this dV by dt is nothing but the rate of change of linear velocity with respect to time is equal to R, where R is the length of the link, d omega by dt is the angular acceleration, that is rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time, is called as angular acceleration. So we get the magnitude of tangential component of acceleration as at is equal to R into alpha. So at means tangential component of acceleration. And why it is tangential? Because we are differentiating the linear velocity with respect to time, and the direction of linear velocity is always tangential. So that is why this at or component of acceleration is known as tangential component of acceleration. So tangential component of acceleration is equal to R alpha, where R is the length of the link and alpha is the angular acceleration. If it is not mentioned in the problem statement, then the component of acceleration which is tangential will be equal to a zero. Or in other case, if the link is rotating with the uniform angular velocity, so in that case also, we will get the tangential component of acceleration as zero. Now, how to draw the acceleration polygon or the acceleration diagram? So there are the four steps. So we have to follow those four steps, then we will be able to construct the acceleration diagram or the acceleration polygon for the given mechanism. So the first step is exactly same as the velocity polygon, or when the step which we use while constructing the polygon, that is velocity polygon or the velocity diagram. So the first step is we have to draw the configuration diagram by considering the suitable scale. That is, we have to draw the mechanism which is mentioned in the problem statement. Then in the second step, we have to velocity diagram for the given mechanism. So this part already we have discussed in the construction of the velocity polygon under the topic velocity analysis by relative velocity method. Then third part is, or third step is, we have to calculate the velocity of the different links from the velocity diagram, and we have to keep the entire thing into the tabular form. So after step number three, we have to make this table. So it consists of the different columns. So first column is of name of the link. Let's say we are having link AB. So put here in this column, put the name as AB. So that is name of the link. Then moving to the next column, which shows the length of the link, which is given a notation of R. So you have to put the, let's say our link is having a dimension of 180 mm. Then we have to put it in meter, that is 0.180 meter. Then velocity of the link, V meter per second. So this is a very important column. These two things you can put from the given data, but velocity of the link, you have to take it from the velocity polygon. So let's say we are having here link AB. We have written its length. Then we have to write its velocity. So what we have to do? Measure the velocity vector AB from the velocity polygon. If you have taken the scale, multiply by scale, and then put the value of velocity of the link V in meter per second. Then next one is acceleration of the link. So to get the values of acceleration of the link, we are having the two components. One is normal component and second is the tangential component. So put the corresponding value and calculate the values of normal as well as tangential component of acceleration. So likewise, it depends on the how many number of links are there, and accordingly we have to calculate the corresponding values. Let's say if you are having the 4-bar mechanism, then corresponding to 4-bar mechanism, we have to consider the number of links. Then we have to write the dimension of those links, then velocity, normal component of acceleration, and the tangential component of acceleration. So once this is done, the step number 4 is we have to calculate the linear and angular acceleration of the various links by measuring the different lengths in the acceleration diagram. So again, this is a very important step to calculate the values of the linear and the angular acceleration of the various links. So here we are having the 2 important points in which tangential component of acceleration is 0, and in the second case the normal component of acceleration is 0. So we have to see in which condition we get the magnitude of tangential component as 0 and in which case we get the magnitude of the normal component as 0. So in the first condition, when the link rotates at the constant speed, then its angular acceleration becomes 0. And when the angular acceleration is become 0, then the tangential component of acceleration also becomes 0. So in such a cases, when we talk about the total acceleration, then it is equal to the normal acceleration of the link. So whenever we are having a condition that when the link is rotating with the constant speed, tangential component is 0, because angular acceleration is 0, and the total acceleration will be equal to the normal component of acceleration. So that is the first point we have to make the note of it. And the second point is that the normal component is 0 in the case where the slider is moving along a straight line. So in this case, we are having the normal component magnitude 0, because for sliders, radius is infinity. So in such a cases, the total acceleration is equal to the tangential acceleration of the link. Now we will start with the actual problem based on the acceleration analysis. So here is the problem statement. So first of all, with this problem statement, we will try to understand what are the different steps we have to follow for the acceleration analysis. As discussed earlier, we have to construct the velocity polygon prior to the acceleration polygon, so which we have studied earlier. So we will go through it quickly, and then we'll spend more time on the construction of the acceleration polygon or the acceleration diagram. So let's start with the problem. So we are having the problem statement that in a 4-bar mechanism A, B, C, D, AD is fixed and crank AB rotates at 200 RPM in the clockwise direction. The dimension of the various links are as follows. BC is equal to AD is equal to 150 mm, CD is equal to 80 mm, AB is equal to 40 mm, and we are asked to find the angular velocity of the link BC and CD. And in addition to that, the angular acceleration of link BC and CD. So if you consider this problem till the angular velocity calculation, then it is limited to only a velocity analysis. But we are, in addition to that, we are asked to find the angular acceleration. So to get the values of this angular acceleration for the link BC and CD, we have to construct the acceleration polygon or the acceleration diagram. Let's start with the solution. So in the step number 1, we have to write the given data. So speed of the crank is given, which is 200 RPM. Then the dimensions of all the links are mentioned. Then in the step number 2, we have to write the things which are asked to calculate. So we are asked to calculate the linear velocity and angular velocity and the angular acceleration for the link BC and CD. Then in the step number 3, we have to draw the configuration diagram, that is the diagram
or the given mechanism with the specified dimensions. Then in the state number 4, we have to calculate the linear velocity for the input link. So here the input link is AB. So the formula is B is equal to R omega, and the speed is given, that is 200 RPM. So first of all, we will calculate its angular velocity. Omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. We have used this formula, so put the corresponding values. So once we get the value of the input link as 20.943, then we'll start with the linear velocity calculation. So for linear velocity, we are having a standard formula as V is equal to R omega. Then put the corresponding values and we get the linear velocity as 0.8377 meter per second. So once we get this, then we'll start with the velocity polygon as discussed earlier. So I'm not going into the details of this. So already we have studied this, but it is the step in the acceleration polygon that we have to draw the configuration diagram, velocity polygon, prior to the acceleration diagram. So here is the velocity polygon. Then after completion of the velocity polygon, we are asked to calculate the linear velocities, angular velocities for the link BC and CD. So we'll calculate those two velocities. So here is the angular velocity for the link CD, and here is the angular velocity for the link BC. So we have done with the first part. Now in the second part, we have to calculate the angular acceleration for the link CD and BC. So for which we have to construct a acceleration diagram or the acceleration polygon. So we will start with the acceleration diagram. So to start with the acceleration diagram, first of all, we have to make the table as discussed earlier in the procedure. So here is the table for the acceleration diagram or for the construction of acceleration diagram. So in the first column, we have to write the name of the link. So link AB, BC, CD. Then we have to write the length of the link, which is mentioned. So it is 40 mm, 150 mm. And 80 mm. So we have to write these in meters. So we have converted these values to a meter. Then next is velocity of the link V in meter per second. So to get this velocity, what we have to do, we have drawn the velocity polygon. So for the link AB, or to get the linear velocity of link AB, measure the length of vector AB. If you have taken the scale, multiply by scale, so you will get this value, that is 0.837 meter per second. So likewise, we have to do for BC and CD. So to get the linear velocity of the link BC, what we have to do, measure the length of the vector BC in the velocity polygon, multiply by scale, you will get linear velocity for BC as 0.45. Similarly for CD, you will get this as 0.51, which is equal to length of the velocity vector of link CD multiplied by scale. Now the next column is acceleration of the link. So for the acceleration, we are having the two different components. So first component is called as normal component of acceleration, and the second one is called as tangential component of acceleration. So first of all, what we will do, we know the magnitude of linear velocity for all the links and we know the lengths of all the links. So we'll calculate the normal component magnitudes for the all the links. So for link AB, it is V square, so 0.837 square by 0.04. Similarly for BC and for CD. So coming to the tangential component of acceleration, when we talk of AB, then its value is 0. Because in the problem statement, it is mentioned that the link AB is having a uniform speed of 200 RPM. Or if it is not, even though if it is not mentioned, then the values of angular acceleration is not provided for the input links, which also indicates that the tangential component of acceleration is 0. Then coming to the link BC, we don't know the magnitude of the tangential component of acceleration, but what we know is the direction of the tangential component of acceleration for the link BC, and which is perpendicular to the BC or parallel to the velocity vector of the link BC. Similarly for CD as well, we don't know the magnitude, but we know the direction which is perpendicular to the link CD. So likewise, we have to complete this table. So once we get this table, then we have to start drawing the acceleration polygon or acceleration diagram. Okay. So this is a configuration diagram, so you need not to draw it again. So already we have drawn in the second or third step. I have taken this diagram here just for the sake of simplicity, or just for the sake of reference I have taken, as I was not able to accommodate the entire things on the one page. So that's why I have taken this configuration diagram for the sake of reference to draw the acceleration polygon. So let's start with the acceleration polygon. So what we have to do, how many fixed points we are having in the configuration diagram? 2 points exactly, the point A and point D. So these 2 points we have to represent by the single point in the acceleration diagram. Okay, so before that we have to choose a scale for the acceleration diagram. So here we have chosen the scale for acceleration diagram or the acceleration polygon as 1 centimeter will represent a acceleration of 2 meters per second square. So we have taken the 2 fixed points. Those will be represented by the single point in the acceleration diagram. So here is the single point which will represent point A and D from the configuration diagram. Now we will start with the input link AB, which is having a only normal component of acceleration, and its tangential component is 0 as it rotates at the uniform speed. We know the direction of the normal component of acceleration, which is along the link and towards the point A. So in the acceleration diagram, we have to draw the parallel line to the link AB and away from this point. So here is the point B, and this is the normal component of acceleration for the link AB. That is the acceleration of point B offset from point A, and which is equal to the total acceleration of the link AB. Next, what we have to do is we have to draw the normal component for the link BC. So the normal component of link BC is along the link BC or parallel to the link BC. So here we are having the point B. So draw a parallel to the BC through point B, and the whose magnitude is 1.35. So 1.35 we have to represent according to this scale. So here we have the normal component of acceleration for the BC. So this is point B, this is point C dash, and this is the normal component of acceleration for the link BC. Now coming to the tangential component of acceleration for the link BC, we don't know its magnitude, but what we know, its direction. So now it is perpendicular to the link BC. So draw the perpendicular to the link BC through point C dash. So this is the direction of the tangential component of acceleration for the link BC. Now moving to the point, or moving to the link CD, again it is having a normal component, and for its tangential component we don't know the magnitude, but what we know is its direction. So draw the normal component for the link CD, which is having a magnitude of 3.25 meter per second square. So according to this scale, we have to draw the normal component. So here is the normal component of acceleration for the link CD. Now, the tangential component of acceleration of the link CD is perpendicular to the link, and it will pass through this point and will intersect to the tangential component of CB, and we will get the point C. So here is the point C. So this is normal component for the link CD, and this is the tangential component for the CD. So we have drawn all the components of all the links. Now we have to get the resultant or the total acceleration. Now to get the total acceleration of the link BC, what we have to do? We have to join B and C, and to get the total acceleration for the CD, we have to join point C and D. So here we have joined the point C and D, and which will represent the total acceleration for the link CD. Similarly for BC, join these two points B and C, which is representing a total acceleration for the link CD. So in this way, we complete the acceleration diagram or the acceleration polygon for the given basic four bar mechanism.
Now we have to start with the calculation of the angular velocities for the link BC and CD. So once we complete the acceleration polygon, then the remaining task is very easy. Just we have to take the measurements and we have to put the values. So for the link BC and CD, to calculate the angular acceleration, so first consider the link CD. So where we get the angular acceleration? We get the angular acceleration alpha in the formula of, or in the magnitude of, the tangential components. So to calculate the alpha for the CD, consider the tangential component of acceleration for the link CD. So we have to measure the length of CC dash. So this vector CC dash represents the tangential component of acceleration. So from the configuration diagram, from the acceleration polygon, you have to measure the length of vector CC dash and multiply by scale. So 8.4 into 2, so it which gives the tangential component of acceleration as 16.8 meter per second square. Now, similarly, for tangential component of CB is represented by vector CC dash, so measure its length and multiply by scale. So we get the tangential component of acceleration as 15.4 meter per second square. But we know that the tangential component is related by this formula with angular acceleration. The tangential component of acceleration is equal to r into alpha, where alpha is angular acceleration. So the same formula we can apply for the link BC and CD, and by substituting the corresponding values, the unknown will be alpha, and that which can be calculated. So for link CD, if I apply this formula, then we can write ATCD is equal to CD into alpha CD. So ATCD is known, CD is known, just we have to put alpha CD. So we will get the alpha CD, that is the angular acceleration of the link CD, which is 210 radian per second square. So this is our answer for the angular acceleration of the link CD. So similarly for link BC, we have to do. So ATCB is equal to CB into alpha CB, put the corresponding values and get the value of angular acceleration of the link CB. So here is the complete solution for the given problem, and this is how we use the acceleration polygon to calculate the angular acceleration of the various links. Thank you.